the shear resistance of the power caps, there are three critical sections that you need to check, as illustrated here. First, we look at the critical sections at pi per phi inside the power phase. Referring to this section here, the critical sections will be here, which is located at an offset distance of pi per phi from the surface of the pulse. As the centroid of the pulse caps fall outside this critical section here, the total shear load sustained by this shear plane will be governed by the reactions generated by these two pulses. That will be your VED. While checking for the critical section here, the existence of the power underneath it will provide some form of shear enhancement. This shear enhancement by the pulse here will decrease the shear force VED to AV per 2D. The AV here is determined by the distance from the column face to the critical sections. The D will be referring to the depth of the reinforcement bar from the top surface of the power caps. While considering the shear enhancement for these critical sections, you will need to check the spacings between the piles. In the case that the spacing between the piles L is less or equals to 3 times the pile size, the entire section here will undergo shear enhancements. However, if the L exceeded 3 times the pile size, the enhancement will only apply to a strip of 3 times the pile size from the centers of the piles. That means it is only valid for the regions of 1.5 times the pile size and another 1.5 times the pile size. Same goes to this strip. In another word, regardless the spacing of the pile, whether it is less than 3 times the pile size or more than 3 times the pile size, you will need to design for the critical sections of pi per phi inside the pile face. Both will need to consider for the shear enhancement, except that for the case where the L is less than 3 times the pile size, the shear enhancement is considered throughout the critical sections. As for this case, the shear enhancement only occurs at the strip of 3 times the pile diameters from the centroid of the piles. Next, you will need to check for the critical sections for the punching shear of 2D diameter from the column surface. This is very identical to the punching shear check for the pad footing. However, it is noted that when the pile spacing is less than 3 times the pile diameter, you can ignore the punching shear at the perimeter of 2D. This is probably due to the shear enhancement generated within the regions of 3 times the pile size. However, if the spacing goes beyond 3 times the pile size, you will need to check for the punching shear at the perimeter of 2D. Next, you will need to check for the critical sections at the column face, which is the punching shear of the column face. Again, this is very identical to the design for the punching shear at the column face for the pad footing. The vertical load here will be equal to the axial load generated by the columns, and the perimeters of the column face will be equal to 2 times the B plus 2 times the H.